The fact is, it's a constant cash drain. They're highly dependent on federal government and state incentives for money, which constantly flows in. They have capital raises all the time. Even the high-end cars that they build now cost more to build than they're able to sell them for.
You had said in June that you would give up the short once Tesla begins making money, and the predictions on that aren't until what? Later this year at the earliest, but analysts probably thinking second half of 2018.
Not even later this decade.
Which actually took testimony from 11 former executives who said in the lawsuit complaint, you can find it, that they all told Elon that there was no way they were going to make the production numbers on the Model 3.
We know you've been public on Tesla for a while. Mm-hmm. What would it take for you to throw in the towel?
Last 150 points, unfortunately.
Last 150 points. What would it make, what would have to happen for you to throw in the towel and say, I give up on this short, this is not going
to
work?
I think I'd have to see the company actually begin to make money selling products.
I've, for the past 3-4 years, hated Tesla. You looked at it, every car company goes out of business. When are they going to make money? When are going to people look at them as a car company? And only looked at the small, you know, bumper sticker, meme-like thoughts on Tesla, and not the deeper ones. And as a short seller, the most important thing you have to do is check your thesis all the time and see when things change. And when they started with Model 3, and the launch, and the production, and the numbers, and how they were eating from the top and the bottom, and I realized it wasn't an EV revolution in this country. It was a Tesla revolution. The people want to own the Teslas.
Yeah, this is the demand problem issue that they say demand's at the heart of the problem. You know, look, I don't know. Can you really have your... I question this piece of research. I mean, on the one hand, he's talking about $10. On the other hand, he's talking about a much higher price. On the one hand, he's saying, listen, there's a real issue here. On the other hand, they just put part of the underwriting.
You're going to check out. It would not be a day, would it, without a discussion of Tesla?
Got it.
Would
it? Market's open.
We talked about it last night. We're going to talk about it again. Shares of the company topping the tape in today's session. It passed a major milestone after it delivered more than 100,000 cars in a quarter for the first time ever. And Tesla says it delivered 112,000 in the fourth quarter, far above Wall Street's estimates. The stock touching new all-time highs on the news.
Wolf of Dubai.
Welcome to a brand new episode. Happy Sunday on Tesla Sunday. And we couldn't time this more better in this new decade than just a couple of days, a couple of hours actually, after Tesla announced its biggest release of numbers ever in the Tesla history. You have seen in the intro that Tesla got grilled over the last couple of years, and now is the time for the payback for Tesla and Elon Musk. Therefore, I'm super happy to talk about the Q4 numbers as well as other topics here in this vlog, and be sure to be ready for a couple of highlights of this week of Tesla. So we will talk about the delivery numbers, obviously. We will talk about the Q4 earnings. We are talking about the short seller letter by Mark Spiegel. He's one of the most famous short seller of Tesla. We will talk about the Tesla Chinese New Year's Eve incentive. We will also talk about new, brand new breaking news from Mercedes. They are actually bad news, so that's definitely good to know what happened there on the competition side. And also we will talk about the China Gigafactory production, as well as the Tesla music video, and of course the Tesla stock as well. So stay tuned and let's roll. So it was long awaited, but finally here. Just before the stock market opened on Friday, Tesla released numbers, and oh boy, 367,500 Tesla vehicles Thank you very much, Elon Musk. And this is a new record of ever sold by a company electric vehicles in 1 year. Just looking in the numbers, they just read so beautifully. As a Tesla investor, you can see that the Model S and X sold about 19,450 and the Model 3 90 to 550. This came to a total of 112.00 cars, and just 8% of these cars are leasing cars. And this actually means something very good for Tesla, because when the cars are less leasing, Tesla is getting the money directly after delivery and write paperwork. This is when Tesla says that a car is delivered, when all the paperwork is done and the handover is done with the client as well. So these are record numbers for Tesla, and I'm sure the whole Tesla family, the whole Tesla staff, the team, everybody is happy, as well as we as investors. Such a great run, but we come later on to this talk as well. The next most important milestone as a next date is definitely the Q4 earnings, which will be long awaited by investors like maybe you and me, because after we know the delivery numbers, we have a kind of peak what the revenue and profit might look like. And I feel, or I strongly feel, after the Q3 that Q4 can be a quite successful quarter for Tesla with this record numbers, as well as low leasing percentage. And this means that the revenue can be quite high. There's a couple of range by different analysts, from 7.5 billion to down to 6 billion. I believe that all in all, we can expect something around 200 or 300 million profit. This would be great. If there's more, then this would be absolutely insane, and the stock can go up and up. Just recently, analysts are saying that the stock can go up even to $500-$600 from here, and I believe this can pretty easily happen when the numbers are really, really outstanding. So, but obviously, once this numbers, the delivery numbers are out, also the expectations are a little bit higher, so we have to see where expectations and numbers really meet in the end. And I'm very curious, on the 29th of January, after the market closes, Tesla will issue the Q4. So if you are a Tesla investor or a Tesla follower, you should get used to the name Stanfield Capital. This is the hedge fund from a very aggressive short seller of Tesla, which is Mark Spiegel. And he actually just released his letter that they are obliged to send to investors of their fund, explaining what they did, why they did what they will do in future to make more money. And I was reading it because I believe that if you're a proper investor of a company, you should not only read the bull side, but also be very close to your enemies, to your short seller, especially the short seller community for Tesla is quite huge. And this is one of the main kingpins of the short sellers. And actually, he's saying in his investment letter following: friends and fellow investors, for December 2019, the fund was down 11.4% net of all fees and expenses. By the way of comparison, the S&P was up 3%, the Russell 2000 was up 2.9%. For all of 2019, the fund was down, and now hold your horses, 6.5%, while the S&P was up 31.5% and the Russell 2000 was up 25.5%. Since inception of June 1st, 2011, the fund is up 53% or 53.7% net, while the S&P 500 is up 187.5% and the Russell 2000 is even up more than double with 121%. And by reading this, I'm just thinking, who the hell is investing with this fund? Because it seems to be really, really bad performance compared to the index. And as you might know, nobody can hit long-term the hits and the positivity of the index. So hedge fund itself is the difficult topic. But another quote that I loved by Mark Spiegel is actually because he's saying there's lot of money into the market, cheap money by the Fed as well. It's like especially shorting is very difficult, and he's actually cutting his Tesla positions in half. Just 10% of his fund will be in future short Tesla from 20%. I guess also because the stock of Tesla went so high in December, that's why also his fund is so bad in December. And he actually made a great comparison saying that to short something in this market is like is like playing poker against someone that has a chips producing machine on their lap. So I can partially agree on that. Indeed, I would not short anything in this bull market. That's very, very difficult. And another topic that I just saw is that since 2018, considered the short sellers, they lost about $3 billion, and this is huge, guys. I mean, they could build their own gigafactory for that money. And I couldn't resist to make a small picture about that. And another good reasoning for that, I can just say, dear short sellers, don't short the future or long the past. And therefore, let's dive into the next one. So Tesla is doing an initiative. So by the subsidies of the Chinese government, they are reducing the price of their cars to below 300,000 Chinese yuan. And they're making just one condition. You have to order your car before the Chinese New Year's Eve. Now the Chinese New Year's Eve, you have to understand that in China, most or all companies are closed for 1 week, 2 weeks, and all the people that are working in factories are going to their villages and other countries and other cities just to have fun or to visit their families. And therefore, also Tesla will be closed for sure for a week or two or 10 days. And therefore, you can expect end of, I think the Chinese New Year's Eve is 25th of January. So about end of Jan until beginning of February, there will be no cars produced in China, and also lots of people will go outside the country, so there will be also maybe less sales expected in this period as well. So very important, 25th of January. Another funny fact or a funny breaking news I came across is the Mercedes EQC. Now you see this car everywhere. You see it in ads, you see it on YouTube, you see it on with different influencers, you see it on print media around your city, you see it on events, exhibitions. But then I came about this news that a reporter in Germany actually tried to figure out how many cars are actually sold. And they are actually produced in the city where I came from, Bremen in Germany. And actually one of my friends said, hey, I have seen one, but maybe it's always the same. And maybe it's just a test car. And maybe it is true, because in November, the car got sold just 19 times. This is 19. Just to compare it, the Tesla Model 3 sold about 30,000 times just in Netherlands. So this is really ridiculous numbers. Then, and I did a nice touch that the reporter actually said in the article was that Mercedes is losing their DNA, because in the end they was the one who building the engine, the most important part of the vehicle. Now they are buying the electro engines, they are buying the battery pack. So where exactly is the Mercedes DNA there? So very, very good article, but I wanted to share this because competition is something that should bring Tesla down, right? Another very, very, very good point was actually in the delivery numbers, because there was one sentence that was really, really big. Actually, there was two sentences. First one was they attested 3,000 Model 3 production capacity within 1 week. And this is huge. By confirmed was 1,000 per week. Now it's 3,000 already tested. This mean that just with a, you know, snip of a finger, or more or less, Tesla can produce 3,000 Model 3s per week. This is 12,000 per month, and is very, very close to the 150,000 cars that they want to put out next year or end of 2020 out of this factory. And I believe they showed us that they built this factory just in a couple of months. So I believe that this ramping up is really easily for them by all the experience that they have from the Gigafactory in the US, just copy and paste. And the second big news was actually in China, that they are mid or late December, they started to use local battery packs. This means that they are actually using locally produced battery packs that is most probably from LG Shem already, which is the LG battery pack producing company that will partner up in Tesla in China. And this means also they are saving a lot of tariffs on these battery packs if they are using them already in the cars of the Model 3. So there is a new music video out there, which is by the guys Jack Boys Gang Gang. And this is actually a rap style music video, and they are on a kind of old car place, and they are actually, you know, rapping around, and then they are showing the Cybertruck and also the ATV, Cyber ATV, which is great marketing. Obviously, this video has already 8.4 million views and 1 week ago posted. So I just cannot stress enough how much free marketing of Tesla is in the internet without them paying one single dollar. Like every influencer buy their Tesla's cars, they are showing them to the fans. They, you know, they show and tell the people and the camera and their millions of fans how great Tesla cars is. And I just, this kind of moves is really interesting for Tesla as from the marketing perspective, as well as you have to consider that this is all non-paid. So even though Mercedes is putting so much money on marketing and selling 19 cars, Tesla is not endorsing any influencer or paid marketing and selling 100,000 of cars. So here we go. Last but not least, let's look into the Tesla stock. The Tesla stock is in a very bullish scenario over the last couple of weeks. If we can see here, just in the beginning of last month until now, they moved up 35% almost. This is really impressive. Moreover, if we are looking in the whole week, then you can see that from the 27th of December till now, they just got 2% up. But if you're considering from just this year, so 2nd of January till now, would be around 3.9% just on the last day of trading. Obviously, the stock went up 3% on a very, very bad market day. This is very potential to the new week. If everything politically gets a little bit more relaxed than on a good day, I think this will have an aftermath of having the stock further going up. Now, but I want to stress something more. Now, we are about having a market cap here of 79, or let's say $80 billion. Now, $80 billion is just shy of VW, which is the biggest car manufacturer in the world. So this means just by the valuation, Tesla is the second biggest car manufacturing company in the world. But wait a second. There is a problem, in my personal opinion, that Tesla shouldn't be called car manufacturing company, because in the end they are a transportation company or a going to transportation company, as well as an energy company, as well as a very, very tech and software lasting company. So manufacturing part is, yes, still a big part, but will transit over time. And I believe that this is very important to know, that this is just the beginning, guys. Now, you have seen the intro with the analyst that said, you know, especially Jim Chazos, who's saying, hey, if the company will make money, I'm out of the short. And I think we are now in the turning point, and I would be not surprised if in the coming weeks, especially when the Tesla will post a profit, and then maybe in April, May or June go into the S&P 500, the biggest or the best market index for US American stocks, which would give them another exposure to index investing. And therefore, I believe that this is maybe the time when Jim Chazos say, hey, this is just maybe he was right in his believing or by his numbers or by his models, but he is just too expensive to hold this shorts on. So I believe this will be a very, very interesting year for Tesla. So stay tuned, subscribe, like this video. Thank you very much for watching. See you tomorrow, because I'm vlogging every single day.